Hi, and welcome back to OpenLCA Tutorials. Today we're going to talk about some basic functions in OpenLCA, namely how to create flows, processes, product systems, and projects. To do this, we're going to go through a simple example, how to create a bottle and transport it a certain distance. So we're going to be looking at a water bottle, which is most commonly made of polyethylene terephthalate, so PET. We're going to be looking at granulate, transporting it, and including a bit of electricity for the manufacturing process. I'm going to be using OpenLCA 1.4.1 beta 6. I'll put a link to the most recent version of OpenLCA in the description box below. So let's get started. First of all, you would start by creating a flow. A flow represents the flow of products and materials within your model. So to create a flow, right click on the flow icon in the navigation window and hit new flow. So for our bottle, let's just name it bottle. The flow type is going to be a product, that's what we're creating, and the reference flow property is number of items. We want to look at the number of items, the number of bottles we produce, and finish. And in the editor, you can see the flow that we've created. So now we need to create a new process so we can produce or modify the flow. So basically produce the bottle product we just created. Create a process, right click on the process icon and hit new process. So the name, we want to produce our bottle, so let's name it bottle production. We don't need to create a new flow for this process because that's what we did in the previous step. So let's just select our quantitative references, reference the bottle, and finish. And the new process opens up in the editor. So now we can select input for our bottle production. So let's just oversimplify the bottle production process and say we need plastic granulate, transportation, and a bit of energy. So the plastic granulate, which is produced in a previous step, needs to be transported to the factory where it's then melted and formed or blown into a bottle shape. To include input in your process, click on the green icon here on the right, and you can filter to look for flows that you're interested in. So let's look for our transport. I know that it's called transport, freight, not sure, let's check, land transport, other land transport, let's say smaller truck, 3.5 to 7.5 metric ton, Euro 5, it's just a standard, and let's take the rest of world flow. The second item we want to look at is the electricity. So electricity, low voltage, and just search our way through until we find what we're looking for. Here are the different regions, so let's just pick Canada, Ontario. Okay. And finally the PET granulate we're going to be working with. And here you have the amorphous granulate and the bottle grade, so we'll take the bottle grade and the flow for rest of world. Let's set the units that we're going to look at. So for the transport, I'm going to change it to kilogram kilometers. We can leave the electricity at megajoules, and kilograms is also okay for the granulate. So you have two options when you want to type in the amounts. You can either type the amount directly into the window here, or you have the option to use parameters. Let's look at how we could use parameters to set the amounts for this example. Basically, we have three different parameters that we can set, namely kilograms, kilometers, and the amount of energy. So we can add parameters by clicking on the right plus button again. Let's add a parameter for the weight, the mass of the plastic that we use in the bottle. Let's say we use about 60 grams in one bottle, so that's 0.06 kilograms. And the distance we're going to transport the PET granulate we can define by D. I'm going to set that at 200. I can change the values for these parameters on higher levels, on the product system and projects level, but it makes sense to set them on the process level to the best of your ability. And if you want to change them on a different level, that's also possible, but if the values are left at 1 and you forget to change them, then you might have a problem in your calculation later on. So for the energy required to produce the bottle, I found in a paper that stated that the process for producing preforms and then turning them into the bottle requires about 20 megajoule per kilogram of plastic bottle produced. So basically, the amount of electricity required is dependent on the weight of the plastic used in the production process. So I'm going to actually create a dependent parameter for the electricity, which is basically the 20 megajoules times the weight of plastic that we have. So now we've set up parameters. Let's go back to the input and put them in the amount field. So our transportation is kilogram kilometers. So that's going to be our mass times the distance. Here our energy in megajoules is just E, and the kilograms is M. And if you want to see the actual values for these parameters, you can click on this button here and see what the actual calculation is. To find out more on how to work with parameters and what's possible with parameters, we also have a video on that, so I will put the link to that also below in the description box. So before we go to the next step, we should look at our default providers. If I click here, you can see that I have the option between the flow transport rate lorry, allocation default unit process, or system process. And the reason for that is the database that I'm using has both the system processes and unit process databases together. So I can here select which one I want to use for my provider. So I'm going to click unit process for all three of these. So now, in order to calculate the impacts of this process, I need to create a product system, which is basically a network of processes. There are two ways to create a product system. You can either go to the general information tab of this process and click on create product system, or in the navigation window, you can right click on the product system icon and click product system here. But before I do that, I'm going to make sure to save this process, and then we can just click on this button here. So we can leave the name as it is or change it however you like. I'm not going to connect the processes because I want to make a point and select the reference process is the one we just created. So let's click finish. And here's the product system we just created. Let's take a look at the model graph. Here you can see our bottle production and our inputs, but the inputs aren't connected because we didn't select that while producing the product system. But we can do that now by right-clicking in the input field and selecting search providers for. And I can search my providers for electricity. And also here I have the option to choose which provider I want to use. So again, I'm going to select to add and connect the unit processes. And I'm going to do that for all three of my inputs. And now we can just save this product system. And we're basically ready to calculate our results. I could change the parameters, the values for the parameters at this point, but since we already added values beforehand, I'm not going to do that right now. But why don't we just calculate this product system and see what comes out. Let's select CML baseline and look at the quick results. And here you can see for the example that we set in, namely that we're transporting 200 kilometers, we've got one bottle weighing 60 grams and a bit of electricity, 20 megajoules times 0.06, and this is the results that we get from that. Another way to look at results is by using projects. The project feature in OpenLCA can be used to calculate and or compare product systems with another. To create a new project, right-click on the project icon and select New Project. And I'm going to name it Bottle Production Situations. So we're going to look at different cases for how to produce a bottle. Let's make sure to save that product system that we used, and then we can close all of these windows. Okay, so here's the project view. We can select the impact assessment method that we want to use here. Let's say CML baseline again. I'm not going to use any normalization and weighting. And here you can select the impact categories that you want to look at. let's just look at the global warming potential. So I'm going to deselect all the other categories. And then I can select my variance. So basically, if I select the plus button, I can see all of the product systems I have in this database. And in this case, I only have one, the bottle production that we made. So I'm going to select that. And if I select it again, then I can, for example, here, change the amount of bottles that I want to produce. So let's say I want to compare the results. If I produce 1,000 bottles compared to if I produce 10,000 bottles. And basically, we can save and create a report right from that. So let's see. As here, you can see that for the category climate change, the results for variant 2, producing 10,000 bottles, is obviously much higher than if I produce one. And here, here are the results shown together relative to one another. So the higher value is shown as 100%, and the lower value is a percentage of the 100%. You can export all of the results from our report as HTML using this button here. Another option you could use is to change the parameters that you've set on the process level. So let's add the parameters that we have. And let's say we don't want to transport the bottle 200 kilometers, but we want to transport it 500 kilometers to see what the difference is. So let's set the amount as to being the same, or it's kind of an unfair comparison. So basically, in case 1, variant 1, we're looking at a travel distance of 200, and in case 2, a travel distance of 500. So we can save that and click on report again. And here you can see what those figures result in. And basically, you can continue to select different amounts and different parameter values to compare different situations, which is really practical for scenario analysis. That's all we wanted to look at for today. If you have any questions on this video or any other videos, or you have some requests, feel free to leave comments below or write us an email directly.
So thanks for checking out the video. I hope it was helpful, and we'll see you next time.